Table for Four, and I'm in Brooklyn today. We took a field ride to see my really great friend, Billy Prestia. The cool thing is we're going to be talking to you about his line of soaps, and then we're going to, his hobby and passion is music, and he's going to be jamming with Scratch That Music, so stay tuned for that as well. But Billy, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
His soaps are fantastic. Clean Essence. They're just 100% natural, and I used to pick them up at the farmer's market years ago. That's how we became friends. So tell me about your soaps.
For starters, they're cleaning and refreshing. They're organic. They are great.
85% organic. That's amazing. And you make them at home in Long Beach?
I converted my garage into my soap factory. Some of my neighbors tell me that I'm the mad scientist going into his laboratory.
We have to go check it out one day because it really is fantastic products.
Yeah. He's the Breaking Bad of soap.
Yeah, that's what they like to call me.
The Breaking Bad of soap. I dig that.
Well, anyway, this one here is my lavender.
And you got juniper.
Lavender is great. It will put you at ease. It's great for de-stressing. If you like, just put this bar right next to your pillow and it will just knock you out. And some people purchase my soap because of the aroma. I use organic or wildcrafted organic essential oils. I don't use any synthetic, no BS from commercial. And this one here is my juniper berry, which they actually make gin out of junipers. And this is like the man bar. For all you men out there who don't think soap is going to clean you, this is the bar.
You know what's funny? I was really a big fan of liquid soap for many years, and when I met you, you got me back into the bars, because like you said, it does fragrance the room. I leave them in like any room, like I'll buy 4 or 5 of them at a time, and you just put them in separate rooms, and it really does give such a beautiful aroma to the room, and it's all natural. You know, a lot of you guys use those plug-ins.
I don't use
and
those.
The chemicals that you're breathing, it's awful. It's
exactly.
All made out of carcinogens and bad chemicals, and this is fantastic. So you can leave one of these bars, if you buy 5 at a time, 6 at a time,
leave them
in the rooms, in your closets and whatnot, and it's just great.
I actually have customers who actually purchase 6 or 8 bars, and they put one in each room, and when they want a new bar, they go into that room and they take the bar.
Mm-hmm.
And they use them as air fresheners also.
So yeah, you got me hooked. You do, like, you break them up in pieces. I know you give them out at the farmer's market. Where can people find you? You're at the farmer's
market? I'm at a couple of markets, but you can also find me online. Just, cleanessencesoaps.com.
cleanessencesoaps.com. So, no, I definitely tell you, these are great stocking stuffers for the holidays.
Yeah, they are.
I think these are fantastic.
I'm taking orders now, by the way.
Okay, no, I believe you, because I know you're laughing. I know you're,
I'm gearing up.
And you also have I shouldn't tell you guys into my little secret, but the anti-aging that you have is fantastic.
Yes, I've been getting a lot of good feedback on that. People tell me that some women who actually purchase it, they actually tell me that they haven't noticed it themselves, but their friends notice it, and their take on it is that they feel that their friends tell them that they look well rested, and they look like, they say, wow, did you get like good sleep or something, or you come back off your vacation or something, because you look great. And that's usually about a week or so after using it.
No, I truly believe, I'm a skeptical, and I'm being honest, I wouldn't be endorsing it if I didn't 200% believe in it, and I use a lot of high-end brands, and when I started using yours...
This is high-end.
Yeah, I use stuff that I made a lot of money for.
Yeah, I know some...
And your anti-aging stuff, that stuff should be, like, everywhere. It's incredible. That's a great stocking stuffer, too. It's a little... How do you sell it? It's like 2 ounces?
I came down, it's about an ounce. And it's cheap. It's not expensive compared to some high-end commercial.
I can vouch for that. I spent a ton of money.
Where there's some big celebrity, pushing it.
It's true. I used to buy all this stuff, and it doesn't work. I don't see the reaction. When I had that, I was skeptical. I said that to you, and it really works. It's really awesome. And unfortunately, you don't have any samples for me today. So
if I knew that you were going to be here, I would have.
Maybe
Maybe
it'll be in my stocking stuffer, right?
Check this out.
Oh, so tell me what you have in there.
My shea butter.
So that's like a lotion, right?
This here is shea butter from Ghana. It's fair trade. It's organic, if I didn't say that. and the women of the village actually make their living.
Wow.
And I had someone come up to me once and say, I have eczema, what do you have? And I gave them shea butter. This little jar, 2-ounce jar, and all you do is just apply it. Like if you have eczema, you can apply it and you will feel the effect of this immediately. Where if you're itchy, scaly, red, you know, flaky skin, this will stop it immediately.
Sometimes it's easier to go back down to basics than buying all these crazy stuff over the counter in drugstores. Get something like this. That's awesome. And what do you have? What's the other little
And the other one is my face body lotion, which I'm going to be changing the name to probably some kind of body lotion because it's a little heavy for the face. I don't recommend people buying it for the face unless you have really dry skin. It's great, but the thing is, for the body,
marketing's my background, so you never
body,
know, maybe I'll
body,
be able to come up with a cool name as the body one for you.
For the body, this is excellent. For your hands, even as a hair conditioner, like today in the show, I used shea butter in my hair. This is
Right
how my hair goes. This is, you could
so
also
you
use
it like
this
a conditioner.
As a hair gel
it's
slash conditioner.
Like, do you use coconut oil at all?
Not
that's
in this.
So big.
No, this is just straight
any
up shea butter.
Any products that use coconut
I've
oil?
I use a lot of coconut, except for my basil soap.
Okay.
No coconut because some people are allergic to coconut.
Okay.
It's lethal to them.
Really?
And I make basil soap which has no coconut.
Okay.
And people actually buy that. I actually made that soap for someone who told me that, can I make them a soap that has no coconut? And I said, and I was talking to them and they told me that they love basil, so I used basil essential oil.
Do the soaps have a shelf life or are they good until...
I would like to say 2 years, but I've had soap in my laboratory where it's over 2 years and it's still good.
Okay.
And the soap actually gets better as it gets, as it actually ages. The soap gets better, it gets gentler, milder. The only downside is that the aroma actually dissipates. Yeah.
Okay.
It's not
I've never had that problem because I go through them like crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
But what I like about them too, these are the exception, but they also have a rough edge to them.
Some
so
of
it
them.
Kind of can exfoliate. I mentioned that to you also.
Yes.
Like that's what I loved about these soaps, that you can exfoliate.
Yes. The lavender soap, I actually grind up lavender buds.
Oh, wow.
As an exfoliator.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, like all the colors, like the tangerine here,
mm-hmm.
I actually put turmeric for the color. And so I use only, you know, the best organic herbs. And
how did you get into making soaps?
That's a long story. The thing is, I really can't go in a supermarket, like the bread aisle and the detergent aisle. It just messes my sinuses up. And all the other soaps out there, the so-called,
mm-hmm.
you know, clean, organic, you know, good, high-end, expensive soap, they would start drying my skin out. So I said, I can't do any
of that.
So
you really basically did it for yourself.
Yeah, I had to make it myself because for my own sanity.
Who pushed you to get this out to the market?
A lot of my friends, they would say, you need to sell this. And after, you know, listening over the years, it was like, okay, it's time to sell it because I give it out to people and everybody comes back and they just wanted more and more and more. And I was like, well, maybe I should try it. Put it outside and see what goes on, like in farmers markets.
Mm-hmm.
And now this year I'm trying to get, you know, on the shelf.
All right, I hope you
yeah,
do.
This
I can't see why you wouldn't make it, because again, these products are amazing. So, where can they go again for a Christmas stocking? I'm telling you, buy 6 at a time, a dozen at a time, easy. Everybody will use them. And a lot of them, there are a few that are allergy free, 100% allergy free, the basil,
yes,
a few of them.
Yes.
So, you know,
a few of them.
Okay, so what's the website?
CleanEssenceSoaps.com.
And if they want to visit you here in Long Island?
No, prefer not to because I work out of my house.
Okay, no, I just meant like some of the farmers
markets.
Oh,
farmers markets.
Yeah, I didn't mean to come to your house.
I'm in Babylon at the, you know, over by the train station in Babylon.
That's a fun farmers market on Sundays, right?
Yes.
That's very cool.
And also on Sunday, I'm in Rockville Center.
All right, cool. So if you guys have something to do,
yeah,
and it's all through the winter too, right?
It's until Thanksgiving, right?
Yeah,
they're going to be ending pretty soon, but you just got to go to my website and you'll just look and you'll see where I'm going to be. And if I'm in stores, I'll be posting it there also.
Alright, cool. Thanks for joining us. And stay tuned for more Billy, his rock and roll song.
Well, these guys over here.
Yeah, the band is here. So stay tuned for a little bit more of Billy with the band. Scratch that music.
Stavro T. Oh, Bill Prestia.
My name is Jorge Olan, and we're with Reelhouse Productions.
Tune into the next project, Table for Four.
Table for Four, and we're here today with my really good friends Stavros, Jorge, and Billy. So thanks guys for coming.
Thank you for having us.
Thanks for having us.
Very excited.
Pleasure.
You guys want to see my what I can bring to the table?
It's a good start.
Oh,
there you go. Hey,
yeah, very cool, very cool.
Why not?
So these guys are amazing. They write music and they produce music. And they did both of my feature films, In Sickness and Fair Market Value. They contributed some music for Fair Market Value also. They did the trailer for In Sickness. The music is insane. So you guys can check it out on YouTube and check it out on our websites, In Sickness and Fair Market Value. So guys, so we're in your neck of the woods. We're at your studio. Thanks for inviting us.
Thank you for having
Thank
us.
Thank you. Thank you for coming
Thank
down.
You.
Very excited. So what are you guys on a typical Thursday night? I know your sessions sometimes go through the night. So what are you guys working on right now?
Well, today we was working on the final mix for a song that we're writing for a European artist out in the Czech Republic. So that was one of our goals today, of finalizing that mix and sending the song to them. I can mention the music entity.
Absolutely.
It's Rocking Planet in the Czech Republic. And so we are contracted to write songs for their artists, and that was one of the goals for today. My name is Jorge Olan.
I am Stavros Tsarouhas.
Stavro T.
I'm Stavro T.
And I'm Bill Prestia.
And I'm your host, Judy San Roman. It's actually a year this week that we shot
they
In Sickness. That's incredible,
That's
right?
Wow. That's right.
Yeah. It
was a year ago.
A year the day?
Yeah, something, yeah, because they started their shooting last November.
Yeah, we're in November.
So it's incredible the journey that we had. You know, we really, it was baptism by fire. I use that term a lot, describing what we went through with In Sickness. But at the end, we ended up with such a beautiful film. So I'm very excited. And, you know, I think you guys heard, we won, Lucas Hassel won for Best Actor, which
That's
is phenomenal, great. In a feature film. And somebody you guys know, maybe won for Executive Producer, you know, so.
That was
this girl right here.
So very cool. So in your music for the trailer, it's just breathtaking. So very cool.
He's like the new James Horner, I'm telling you. Amazing music, amazing songwriter. We get together religiously every Thursday. He's our musical leader, and so we rely on each other. We work long hours, and I can
it's
tell
like
you
that. It's like a family.
That.
It's like
yeah.
my team. Like you have to love, you have to have a passion
right.
for what you do,
yeah.
but you have to love and trust each other because there's no way you can do the hours. The money is not for the money that you guys
no,
are doing it.
No.
You know, it's just
it doesn't
really,
pay the bills.
Yeah, definitely
not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet.
So far,
we're working towards
yeah.
that.
Mm-hmm.
I owe the money for our film too, and I'm putting it out there on Zave. So eventually. Well, let me ask you, Jorge, how did you guys hook up? I love listening to this story. How did you meet Stavros and start working with Billy, and how did this all happen?
Well, this was this is a pretty funny story how it kind of happened, because for me, some people, they say I don't look as old as I am. They say I look younger, but I decided to go back to college to pursue becoming an audio engineer. And so with those efforts of going back to school, I met up with a number of people that shared the same goals in music and in film, and with navigating and meeting people from my own class and other classes, I met up with this guy right here. And when I heard his music, I freaked out. It's just amazing, fantastic music.
You should start shouting.
I told everybody in my class, you need to work with this kid. His music skills, the style of the music that he's writing is just fantastic. I literally went through the whole school telling everybody they have to work with him, because I just felt that for his age, the music that he was writing was like, wow, really different. And so along the ways, we started sharing some of our music. And then after we graduated, it was like some maybe 8-9 months later, he comes back from being on vacation in Greece for like 2 months. Nice vacation, 2 months. He went to Greece, came back.
He was gone this year too.
It was good.
Yeah,
it was good.
So
he gives me a call. He goes, "Hey, Georgie, my batteries are charged. Let's get together and work on music." I'm like, "Yeah, dynamite!" And there you go. Ever since then,
we met up
writing music and songs.
Writing songs and music and just different projects, different minds together. So we started this team, and then Billy came along.
Yes.
Billy's our voice of reason.
But you know what?
Which is another story altogether.
But you know what?
George and I go back like a very long time.
From when I was a teenager.
When
I had hair. Actually had hair.
Well,
he passed my shoulders.
Well, I'm very grateful for Billy, because so many people have given me music and, you know, say, "You got to listen to this and that." And it was like early in the morning. I'm driving to work and I'm playing it. I was just like, "Oh my God, this is awesome." I'm like, "Who are these guys?" And I just couldn't believe the sound. You know, it was like Linkin Park. It was so edgy. It was very cool. So I called him immediately, and you guys have been part of my team since, huh?
Reelhouse Productions. That's the move. We're like writing music, working on the films,
working on some music videos,
post-production
work. Yeah, a lot of very cool stuff.
Something that it's very tedious. It takes a long time. It's amazing. You never really know until you do it. Sometimes it might only be like a 5-minute clip of a film, and you're literally working on it sometimes 2-3 hours and just perfecting the sound to a movie for 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. The end result, usually, when you're happy with the work, it's all worth it. Because then you look at a whole finished project, like when you go to the movie theaters and you see a movie from start to end and it just sounds right. And we literally...
You're proud of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm proud of it.
Well, you guys don't have any other testimonials, just the two features that you guys did with me so far, movie-wise. But, I mean, it's cool to say that I know you've seen each film probably like 200-plus times, just like I have. And people don't realize how much work it goes into. You have to watch it every, you know,
every
second.
Every millisecond.
Yeah, 10 times.
You actually become it.
Yeah, but you guys keep watching it and you still love both films. So that's a very good sign that you will too enjoy this film. So I'm very excited about that, right?
Super
that's a good
excited.
Thing,
yeah.
And can you want to share? I know you did one of the songs also for, if you want to give me a little bit of, like, I'll give you the scenario with In Sickness. We're going to try to edit the clip in so you guys can see Lucas Hassel. He's in the car. And there's a radio, he's changing the stations. You want to tell me a little bit about that scene? What you did with the music?
So, yes, pretty much when we got that scene, when we got that scene, it was just an open canvas for painting. So we had all those empty little clips of Lucas, you know, being in the car, driving to find his wife, his girlfriend, and it was just inspiring because you could put any type of music, but then we literally, you know, we felt how he would feel and what would be maybe at the radio at that time. So we placed a few of our tracks in there, and just the balance of the different genres and the little clips, it just makes it like, you know, I guess an interesting...
Yeah, because it's like he's driving, and so he's changing the stations, and for every time that he's changing the station, it gave us the opportunity to throw in a piece of a song.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's going through maybe, 4 stations or something? So it was like the opportunity of dropping, okay, he goes 3-4 pieces of 4 different songs, and then
very clever.
There's this one little part where the expression on his face matches really well to the way the chorus of that song is. Is it okay to say it?
Absolutely.
Okay, so there's this part where he's singing the lyric, "Is it a losing game?" No, take it back. "I'm a stranger in the crowd."
I'm a stranger in
the crowd. Right. So that was the line. And so when you look at it, and it's like for that moment, it captured the moment so perfectly. We felt proud of
that.
There
are a couple of more parts in the movie like that. Like when they're in the bar and you hear the other song we have placed in there, Strange Affection.
Uh-huh.
And there's this part that says, What is the part?
When he's screaming no, when he's taking the drink when he's not supposed to, because he's drinking and he's also got medication.
And he turns up and looks and he kind of hears the song and it's kind of like, it just blends in
that
so perfect.
That stuff is fantastic when that happens, really.
So I think for you guys, like, it's easier to write music, you read the script of whatever you're working on and then you write music for it. You write, you know, pieces like that?
It's either we read the script or we actually watch kind of an edit of the film so we can feel
the feel of the film
and we see exactly with the acting and the movement and the environment, because all those little things take place when you're trying to score music for a film. Everything from the environment, from the B shots, the wide shots, the everything takes place. So
is there one,
second of somebody
is
turning
one
their
genre
heads,
of music more attractive to you guys than another, like, you know, In Sickness is a drama and Fair Market Value is a romantic comedy. Is one more appealing than the other, or is it a project?
Is that a question music-wise?
Music-wise.
Well, I guess that depends on the personalities of each one of us and what we do like a little bit more to do.
So I know you really like the IDM kind of music.
EDM? Yes.
You really like that EDM kind of music?
Yeah, electronic dance music. Well, honestly, I'm working on having a chance to do everything that I can so I can gain more knowledge, become better. So I could not, for my personal, how can I say this? Okay, let's edit this out.
A personal preference. There's the styles that we like as individuals of music that we listen to. And then there's the music that we know how to compose to film.
Yes.
And there's a lot of different styles. For me personally, I have an easier time looking at a piece of film and trying to capture the moods or the expressions of the person's face. If they're crying or if they're melancholy or something dramatic is happening or a scene that's very action-packed. So I'm able to kind of write in that sort of way. I'm not good at reading the script.
You can actually see the emotional aspect.
Stavros is good. I'm pitching this kid. You know, I'm going to pitch this just like a great advertising product. This kid is fantastic. He knows how to write music from reading the script, and then he also knows how to write music like as I expressed by watching the film.
So I think for jingles, for commercials, for, you know, anything you're looking out there, this team is the team to go through.
I think it all comes down to when you are doing this, it all comes down to being able to put your imagination on paper or vinyl, or recording on the canvas. It's about either film or, let's say, we produce for artists. And you asked me about my personal preference. It would be electronic music because I feel like you have unlimited brushes to fill up the canvas. You can use any sound and that's okay with it because it is electronic music. But when it comes to anything, film, producing for artists, it's literally just being able to train yourself to put that imagination, like the vision you have. What would you like to hear under the video? Or what would be interesting to be heard by the environment while those actors... Imagine in real life if you could hear music in the air.
Absolutely.
Imagine what would that music should sound like for that moment of life. And then just being able to put your imagination and make it happen. And that takes a lot of training, actually.
That's why it's a hearing art. Not a visual.
It is.
Oh, yeah.
It's a hearing art, which is great.
So now, we have something that's happened over the last couple of weeks throughout some of our efforts. We have the song, which is known as Losing Game, right? That there's a USA version of the song that we are doing, where Stavros is singing lead on that. And there's also a zombie video that was released for Halloween, and we would like to show that to you guys as well so you can get an idea of some of the recent things that we're putting out there.
So you know what? We're going to, I guess, right after the interview, we will attach it to this video, to our interview, and you guys will be able to put it out there. How about that?
You know, so then
it's fantastic. Your brother is the lead in the video. It's very cool. So.
He first steps into, you know... really acting for it.
I've seen him in a few things. He's he's doing his stuff. He was in a bunch of stuff for our friend, for Jackie Zeri and stuff. So that's terrific. So we'll attach the video. So what are the two names of the video? So they'll sell to you.
One is called Losing Game by Stavro T. And the other is called Survival, Run for Your Life by Stavro T.
Very cool. So yeah, the Run for Your Life is a zombie one, so you guys will enjoy it at the end. And I'm trying to think, and then you had, I do a lot of things, but one thing I definitely know I can't do, I can't drive. Two things I can't do, I can't drive and I can't sing.
Well,
so because
no
I know
promise
you
that. Yes, there are a lot of people that cannot sing, but I feel like if we put you in the recording booth,
yeah,
we can definitely
sing.
Get
yeah,
you sound.
So get some good sound.
You know, no, all right,
so maybe we'll do a behind the scenes before we leave, like trying something crazy. But no, honestly, I mean, you had Lucy Wood working with you guys, and she
oh, yeah,
helped do one of the songs for
First
Hurt. That's just so beautiful. The ending credit song for In Sickness is just amazing.
Lucy is an amazing artist, amazing person, because we know her personally,
mm-hmm,
and she's so creative, so on point, really great voice, great talent.
Yeah.
And how did you guys find her? Because I know you auditioned a lot of people, and how did you guys?
I found her.
Media.
Yeah. We actually, it's interesting the way sometimes, you know, when you do things, you know, it's kind of meant to be, because we were searching for a female vocalist to sing this particular song that we had written a few months before we had found her. And her name is Lucy Jane Wood. And the thing was is that we knew that the time was coming up where Judy was going to be filming In Sickness, which we knew it was in November. And Jay, who's not here, Jay Tyree, who wasn't able to make it today, was also one of the writers on the song. And we was like, George, what are we gonna do? We need a singer, we need a female singer, we're running out of time. And I had told him, I remembered clearly that it was like, listen, you know, if it's meant to be, don't worry, the singer will come around. We just gotta make sure that we keep looking. If it's meant to be, somebody will pop up. And sure enough, about a week later, between all the people that I was meeting and asking around, I ended up walking into a guitar store, and I spoke to the sales rep there, and then after I left, it was just an instinctive thing. I was like, here, listen, take my card, I'm looking for a female singer. If you know anybody, let me know. And then sure enough, it was like 2-3 days later, I get this email, and it was Lucy Jane Wood, and when I saw the video of her singing, I was like, she's definitely the girl for the song. And then once we met her, it was like instant family with her. She's like amazing personality. We got along like brothers and sisters, and so it was like an immediate adoption. Like, right? Like, we had this girl who can sing with amazing singing vocal skills, and at the same time, her personality blended in with ours, and it just allowed for us to have like this great family thing, and she also committed to making Thursdays the ritual,
mm-hmm,
sacred day for music on a weekly basis. So we was able to accomplish a lot of things with her. And if you get to see this, Lucy, thank you. We wish you a lot of luck out there in Los Angeles.
Thank you, Lucy.
We'll be seeing you in a few weeks. And so it's all good.
Hey,
yeah,
you have to follow her on Facebook, guys. Lucy Jane Wood, she's fantastic. She actually opened up for Stevie Wonder.
She did a show at the Greek Theater several months ago. Stevie Wonder was not able to make the gig, but she did a performance, which was really nice. It was the police commissioner, I think it was, right? It was having some kind of conference in Los Angeles, I think,
mm-hmm,
it was. And she was one of the performers at the Greek Theater. So that
there were a couple of
Some big names with it. I think it was
Chili
like
Peppers, and wasn't it?
I honestly can't remember it.
Red Hot Chili Peppers,
yeah,
were there. That's very cool.
I'm not sure.
Like,
not.
There were
some big names that were floating around, and honestly, forgive me, I can't remember. But yeah, I guess you could always go back and look on her website. The information would be listed as to where she performed. But
she
was there. She was at the Greek Theater.
I think my two favorite words when describing anything in life is passion and purpose, and you guys have that passion and purpose in everything that you guys do. I mean, to spend 15-20 hours on Thursday nights and just jam through, and then you go
to your day job right after, it's insane,
you know? So you have the core. You guys really enjoy each other's company,
yes,
you're fun, and you know, and you're making beautiful music together, so just keep doing that. Right?
Yes.
So you guys are gonna jam with us a little bit. So we're gonna put them on the spot now. Okay. So we're gonna continue back on your keyboards, and we're gonna give you I'm gonna give you a few ideas of a song, and you're just gonna, we're gonna see you live trying to create it, and you guys as a team, okay?
Okay, that could work.
She's gonna play the piano.
Yeah, so so stay tuned a little bit more with the Table for Four. Hold on. Instruments that you can play, right?
Yeah, it's this is my main, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
Piano is something that, keyboards and piano, something I've been doing since 5 years old, actually.
Wow.
So I was kind of like telling you before, I started with keyboards and then moved to classical piano, and then when I was 13 I just fell in love with all the instruments, being that my parents were listening to rock and all, you know, that instrument related
mm-hmm.
music.
Mm-hmm.
old school
mm-hmm. Yes. So
good stuff.
Led Zeppelin.
The good stuff.
Led Zeppelin.
Ozzy Osbourne, and, you know, deeper into the metal, like Cradle of Filth at the time, and all those like crazy...
Metallica.
And then moved to electronic and classical at the same time. So yeah, I started doing the acoustic and the classical guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Moved to the electric, then I bought my first bass, my first drum kit, a little bit at a time.
It's all about the bass.
It's all about the bass.
Mm-hmm.
I
love it.
I remember it right now.
Well, let me see. Can I throw it out there? Can you sing something for us?
We have this new track that we're working on. The second verse of a record we're doing for an artist in Czech Republic.
Okay, very cool.
And
we're going to do
an American version as well.
Okay, very cool.
And the lyrics are pretty interesting. They have a deep meaning. It goes something like, in the rhythm of love, in the rhythm of life, like a restless highway, you're breaking the speed of light, and I'll follow you until the end of time. It's like every 5 years or so, they talk about a new end of the world. So fight for who you love and die for who we are, 'cause we are who we are. And nothing compares to you. Yeah.
That's beautiful.
And the song.
That's one idea.
That's really the soft tempo of this song. Because
yes.
This song
is.
Kicks ass.
This song
kicks ass.
It's a dance groove.
Yes, you can say it.
This song really kicks ass.
It kicks ass.
It's going to be on cable. You can say
yeah.
What's the other song?
Do you want to do a little first heard or.
You,
you
want to
be happy? No. Do whatever you feel like. What do you feel like entertaining us with?
Yeah, you sang a
few. Surprising.
That,
yeah,
right?
Whatever.
Yeah, you are
amazing.
No.
But no, if you're happier, you want to do something.
What else can we play?
You
want to
experiment? Whatever.
You could play
Fever.
Oh,
play a little bit of
this
Fever.
This is another song that I'm preparing for my personal EDM producer project, Stavro T. It's called Fever. And I actually do really love this song, and
right, cool.
I hope it comes out as good as we imagine it. For what we've done, we are even, but can you feel the fever? We used to stand so strong, so tall. I hate to watch you fall. For what we've done, we are even. But can you feel the fever? We used to stand so strong, so tall. I hate to watch you fall. Yeah.
I'm burning up.
Well, the new version is
right.
I'm up all night.
That's right, that's
feel
right.
Feel fine.
Yeah.
'Cause all I ask of you is you.
We're working
through.
On
it. It's giving them through. Don't you walk away from me. It's killing me. Why can't you see? Your fire is burning my skin.
So now, here's this amazing thing that you have to see the flip side of the coin on this, because you're hearing how this is the basic piece of the song with just it
the
being
skeleton.
On the piano,
yeah.
The skeleton of the song. Play.
It's the beginning.
Play
of the
song the way you have it now, as far as the current
with Lucy?
Mix, with the way it sounds,
yes.
With all the instruments and the drums and with the dance groove to it, and the melodies and.
Bells,
it'll
whistles,
give you an
melodies.
Idea,
because
there's this beautiful thing that you learn in music where it says if you can deliver a song with just one instrument and the person singing it and it sounds nice or you could hear it, that you can identify the song, that's when you have a really good song. So this is a perfect example.
It's the acoustic version.
Oh, you have to hear this.
This is the listening version we're working on, and it doesn't have the vocals yet, but you got an idea of how it will sound.
Right, the track itself. At least. Right?
Backup dancer.
Yeah, our DP behind the cameras, Mr. Brian, is dancing.
Brian.
Yeah, he's dancing mm-hmm. back there. I was like, couldn't
the
get
the cameras bouncing
dancing.
Around. I'm sorry, I couldn't help but move it.
Very cool, guys. No, I'm so impressed. All right, so let me just see what you would do. I'm gonna give you maybe two different scenarios and see if you guys can be quick on your feet. Okay.
Okay.
So we're working on a Christmas movie, and it's. It's a nice story about a family who burglar comes in and he gets busted, and it's the meaning of Christmas, you know, at the end what they do for this burglar. So just with that little synopsis, what would you think? How would you collaborate and create? How would the process start? So you have 2 minutes.
So the burglar gets busted.
Yeah.
And the homeowner.
By the homeowner.
Okay.
But they have the spirit of Christmas, so really cool
so
things happen.
Him in,
well,
they,
I can't give away
them.
The story yet, but maybe they don't feed him. Just gonna give you that. But like, for just with that little snippet, what would you do? It's Christmas.
I was thinking something funny. Like, he's a burglar, so obviously there's some crime being committed.
Mm-hmm.
So it could be something like the burglar ended up somehow meeting up with Santa Claus. and he ends up mugging Santa Claus for the toys, and then Santa Claus don't go back to that neighborhood anymore. For Red Hook. So that's one angle.
I like this.
The movie resolves. It's the happy ending.
It is.
So something happy and then something happy again.
Nice.
I like it a lot.
And then something sad.
I like both pieces. It's awesome.
That does sound very nice.
It's
right?
Beautiful. I love
that
it.
Sound-
that because I'm going to use that.
It's on film.
Yeah,
okay,
it's on film. So
let me record it on. Yeah, okay, good.
And also, okay, I'm going to give you one more in front of the viewers. Can you guys come up with a very dark, edgy, I just saw Misery with Bruce Willis and
mm-hmm.
Laurie Metcalf. It was amazing. Mm-hmm. Amazing. I mean, knowing the ending, we were still like blown away. So we have a film, very dark, edgy, like that kind of thing. So what would be dark and edgy?
Was it based on the book?
Yes.
The one with James Caan. He also did the movie where, oh my goodness.
It was fabulous. We had orchestra seats. I went
this
with
dark.
My friend Tracy.
This is
dark. So dark, so dark. So I know you like dark and edgy. Yeah, there you go. I like it.
The dark stuff, it comes easy to me, I think. I like the dark, dramatic music. Oh,
no, that was breathtaking. That was amazing. I really liked it.
The theatrical stuff.
How cool is this, Brian, here? Behind the camera's liking this too, right? So happy. Hope many more years of jamming and collaborating and stuff. So very cool. We are going to take you to their studio as well, and we're going to have Stavros give you a demonstration of what it really sounds to record a soundbite song, and then you guys can fake it and try to help me look at it on video singing and making you guys laugh.
We gotta do
so
that. Yeah. Let's do that.
All right. So cool. So sure. Hang on.
I'm just going to explain a certain number of things that we're able to do here. This studio that we have here is not like a full-blown multi-million dollar studio.
It's a home studio.
But at the same time, we have a lot of equipment that allows for us to accomplish a lot of sound, a lot of music. And so with what you're able to see here between the monitors, the laptop, you have the synthesizer. We have guitars, bass guitars, all types of various programs that allows for us to write music. And so pretty much, like right now, what we have here is a session in Logic, where Stavros is going to come down in a few moments, and he's going to start to set everything up according to how he works, so that this way we're able to record in the booth, the professional vocal booth that we have on the side here. And show you some of the steps that are involved. So, in here, this may look plain, but it is a maze. And I mean a maze, not amazing, but a maze, M-A-Z-E, of hundreds of different things that you can do to sound, and writing music and instruments through MIDI, and various EQs, and like you'll see, like at this moment, like this here is activating a compressor, to compress the sound. This is just like one little window of some detailed stuff that you can do. I mean, if you could think of like when you're watching movies like CSI, can I say that? Yeah? You know, and you see them with these computer programs, like they're able to do all this crazy stuff with audio and everything. This is very much like that. This is
Pro
just
Tools.
You know, and this software is Logic.
Oh, it's Logic.
And we use Pro Tools, which is the premier recording software that's in the industry. So in a few moments, you're going to see some of the stuff that we're capable of doing.
And he's got you on auto-tune.
My name is Frogman.
I love that song.
Sing for us a little bit.
Sing for real. Let's hear it.
Scotch on the rocks. Hey, no surprise. Just pour me some drinks and I'll tell you some lies. There you go. That's it. I'm not a singer.
All right, let's go. Come on, Stavro T. Come on. Let's hear. Let's hear.
Like a wave, like a wave. You came and washed it all away. All away with the tricks that you play. Whoa, is it a losing game with the tricks that you play?
How's that?
That sounds better. What else can we do?
Sing the chorus. Sing the chorus to Strange Affection.
Mm. Yes.
Well, play Strange Affection for my cheers.
First song I turned you on to.
Yeah. This is the first song I heard from you guys,
right?
And that's what made me
when
work
I see
with you guys.
It dancing in the dark, Strange Affection. Whoa. There's no rescue for you.
You got it?
D5O fun.
Giants hollering, run, run.
Stupid desert, dying up the rain.
E-O-A.
Seduction, war. There's no quarter for you.
I haven't heard the song in like a year, dude. I don't remember how to
sing. I'm lip syncing.
For you.
It's coming in.
Ready? Look at that mirror, it's looking at me. Missing a friend I used to be. The rat-tat-tat of the candle wick is evaporating. All my wit, the ching-ka-ching. Let's not lie, pockets losing money on the fly. See the light, see the light. Do we ever see the light? Lost, calibrated multitudes with the shaky, crazy attitudes are slowly sleeping endlessly. Rest is sleeping with the enemy. A sneaky twist. All of it is dark.
Yeah.
That wasn't bad.
That was good. That was really bad. But we can probably keep some parts.
Yeah. Okay, cool. That was good. That was fun.
My best friend, Anne Geiger, I love this girl like my sister. Kurt Abrams, he's my old manager and just a rock in my life, a very inspirational person, mentor. And lastly, my artist friend, Stephen Kogel. So, you guys, this is probably one of the only songs I can sing. These guys are swearing, they're gonna make it sound fun. So, with that said, let's sing Happy Birthday!
Yep, let's do that. Oh, what's that? Okay.
So it's your birthday, so it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Let's do it one more time. Sorry, guys.
That's pretty good.
One more time.
You got some pitch. Go for it.
She's got the Marilyn Monroe version.
Mm-hmm.
She's Spanish and Argentinian. She has to have some sort of singing voice.
I skipped it.
Happy. One more time.
Oh, okay. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Anne, Stephen, and Kurt. Happy birthday to you. So it's your birthday, so it's your birthday. Boom, boom. Happy birthday to my friends. So it's your birthday, so it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you guys. Happiest of birthdays. I'll stop singing, so it'll be a happy birthday. I'll get you a Malibu and pineapple, lots of balloons. I love you guys. I hope you guys, we entertained you today from the studios of my dear friends. They're part of Reelhouse Productions, so look out for these guys. They do great music videos and feature films and commercials and all this great stuff. So I leave you with happy birthday.
That's cute.
It's good.
Mm-hmm.
It is good. The time has come to say goodbye. So I want to say thank you so much for entertaining our viewers and me tonight.
Thank
I had
you.
A lot of fun hanging at the recording studio, so thank you.
Thank you.
Where can our fans find you?
So you can guys find my music and collectively with the guys under my name is Stavros Tsarouhas on Google.
I can't spell that, so it's S-T-R. I still can't spell because I can't see, so start it over.
My name, well, you will find the credits, is Stavros Tsarouhas, and then you can go to my LinkedIn and see, you know, all my profiles about general music that we do, and then you can find my electronic music, which I'm also an aspiring artist in that genre, and it's Stavro T. So my name, Stavros, but Stavro, and then T.
All right, spell it out for us.
It's S-T-A-V-R-O-N-A-T, capital T.
All right, cool. So, and under Reelhouse too, anything that you guys want from these guys, you can get them under Reelhouse Production too. So, very cool.
Awesome.
You're amazing. We're going to be working on so many more projects, so thanks for doing this, all right?
Thank you for having us.
Saying goodbye to the other half. So, George, where can our viewers find you if they want to get you?
I'm easy. Check this out. Look at this. Hey, hey.
He just wants to show you guys his nice business card. You
yeah, because I designed the logo. My name is Jorge Olan. I'm a part of Jorge Olan Music Publishing. Anybody that wants to screen any music for film can go to the website. Or if you want to know me personally, you could always call my telephone number or send me an email for Jorge Olan Music Publishing. I'm one of the nice guys working with Stavro T. And I guess we're like a 1-2 punch kind of a thing, and so hope to hear from you soon. You could always subscribe to his YouTube channel under Stavro T. That would be very, very cool. If you want music for free for the time being, you can email me and I'll get you a free track.
And Christmas is coming up and the other holidays, if you saw Hanukkah and all beautiful holidays, so this might be a present for a significant other. Maybe have you guys write them a beautiful song, make a video. You have a director
this we can
here
do. This we
that
can, do.
Can direct the music video, so that's a pretty special gift. So just throwing it out there. And
like
Billy,
that.
Saving the best for last, right?
I'm
Billy, where can our fans and viewers catch you?
Yeah, I'm Bill Prestia. I own Clean Essence Soaps. Creatively, I work with these guys. These guys are great, and her, and him now. And if you want to find me, cleanessencesoaps.com, easy to find. My card, and these are some of the things that I actually make. My stuff is all organic, and you know, just check it out. And there's my phone number. You can
so
call.
So again, for the holidays, great videos, great gifts. And beautiful soaps and beautiful products for your loved ones. So you got a collective here of beautiful ideas and gifts and all kinds of stuff. So, right? So keep in touch with us. That's all for
Thank
Table
you.
For Four.
Thank
Thanks
you.
For tuning in tonight.
Everything happened so fast.
They're coming!
comes where the hatchet is. Don't ever let them catch you. Don't ever let them put you down. Comes where the hatchet is. Don't ever let them catch you. Comes where the hatchet is. Don't ever let them put you down for your life. Comes where the hatchet is. Run for your life. Don't ever let them catch you. Run for your life. Home's where the hatchet is. Don't ever let them catch you. Don't ever let them put you down. Run for your life. Home's where the hatchet is. Run for your life. Don't ever let them catch you. Run for your life. Home's where the hatchet is. Don't ever let them put you down.
That you play.